Hello friends, this is Durga again from IT Varsity, a one-stop shop to learn all the technologies. At this time, we are talking about HDP Certified Developer or HDP CD in short. And so far, we have covered loading data into Hive table from local directory as well as from HDFS. In this video also, I will try to club multiple learning tasks and try to record one video for both of them. So the first one is loading data into a Hive table as the result of a query. So which means that they are asking you to understand the insert statement. Earlier we have seen the load command where it does load from the files, either from local file system and or HDFS into the target table using a load command. Now we will go to the next level where we understand how to do the insert from a query which is on a table which already exists in Hive. Okay, so typically if you want to do any transformations in Hive and you want to load into another table after doing the transformations, you have to use insert query. And insert have certain limitations in Hive. In the earlier versions, you cannot do insert into table values and insert one record at a time. That was not possible in the earlier versions. In the recent versions, they have added those capabilities. And on top of that, you cannot specify the column names in the insert statement. Unlike in the traditional RDBMSs, you can say insert into table name and you can give a set of columns in the brackets and then values, and whatever columns you have defined in insert into table name in the circular brackets after insert into table name, you have to provide corresponding values, values for each of the corresponding columns in the insert statement. For example, it used to look like this. So if you have the MySQL database, and use retail underscore DB, which is the database name, and show tables. There is a table called departments. It has only two columns. So in the traditional RDBMS, you can say either insert into table name, which is departments in this case, and then values, and then you can give value for each of the column. And so we have two columns, so we have to give two values. One is of type integer and one is of type string. Okay, and then you can insert the record into the table, and also you can say insert into departments and give the column names like this. If you want to just insert few of the columns, or if you want to insert in a different order than the columns in the table, you can specify the column names like this and then values, and then provide the corresponding values for the corresponding columns in the values clause. So both will work, whereas in Hive you cannot specify columns like this. So that is one of the syntax difference between the traditional RDBMSs and Hive. Now I'm launching Hive. And let's say you have a database called retail underscore ODS. And we have different tables here. Which we have seen earlier, and you have orders, orders bucket, orders ORC, where we have to change the table structure. So in orders, you have four columns, order ID, order date, you have several columns, five columns, ID, date, customer ID, status, and month, because the table here is partitioned. And when we actually load from the source table, which is non-partition table, which have only four columns, we have applied the transformation logic to compute the order month. And also for the order date, we try to store it as a date here. And all those transformations are done in the select clause. And then we have ran command such as this, insert into table. So table is mandatory in the syntax, orders. And then you cannot specify the columns, but depending upon the table structure, you have to have those many columns in the select clause. In this case, order ID. And then for order date, we have applied the transformation rules such as from Unix cast and substring to compute the date properly, and then we inserted the data. So I will not be running it again because I have already shown as part of the earlier videos. If you want to revisit, go back to the previous videos in the channel, which are part of the certification itself. So there is a video to So this is the video, create Hive partition table in the certification curriculum, which will cover creating the partition table and then using the insert statement. So you can follow that to understand the simple insert statement. Again, like in load, there are different variations in insert. We have seen insert into table, right? And then we have given the table name. So when you actually try to load the data into that table, for example, we will use cards here, show tables, and here if you do select star from deck of cards and hit enter, there are 52 records in this table. And now if I create another table, create table deck of cards 01 as select star from deck of cards. So we are creating a second table in this. So this is how you can do the CTAS. This is also already explained as part of the earlier videos. Now we will see different variations of insert statement, and we will try to understand the behavior of them. You can write any valid query in the select clause, and as long as the table structure into which you are trying to insert the data and your select query matches, you will be able to insert into a table from another Hive table using this insert statement and select query. Okay, and now you can see select star from deck of cards underscore 01. There are 52 records in this table. Okay, and because we have ran the CTAS. Now if I do insert into table deck of cards 01, select star from deck of cards, and it will again run the query and append to the existing data. So now after running this insert command, if you run select star from deck of cards 01, you will see 104 records. You can see here numrows equal to 104 already. You can do run select star from deck of cards 01, and you can see there are 104 rows here. There is a variation of insert into command wherein you can define overwrite. So if you want to just query the data from the source table and overwrite the existing table, you can do so by specifying overwrite. So in the examination certification, if they ask to overwrite the existing data in the table with the new data, then you have to use this approach. Okay. Okay, it is insert overwrite into table, not into overwrite table. The syntax is incorrect. Into, remove this into, and hit enter. I think insert overwrite table, there is no into. Yeah, so insert overwrite table. So overwrite is to overwrite the existing data, and into is to append to the existing data. Now after running this query, if you run the select on the table deck of cards 01, you will see only 52 rows in the table. Okay, so that will wrap up our insert from existing select query. There are only two variations. One is to overwrite the existing table, and the other one is to append into the existing table. And then the next learning objective is to load a compressed data file into a Hive table. Okay, so here you need to understand that compression runs on top of the file format. So if it is a text file format, and if you compress, it will compress as a text file. If it is a binary file, if you compress, it will compress as a binary file. And when it comes to Hive tables, typically you don't need to worry about doing any changes to the table structure to deal with compression. As long as the file format matches with the compressed file format, it will work. So let me demonstrate you to make it clear. Again, if you go to my GitHub account, go to data, you can download the repository from here. Once you download the repository under the cards, there is this largedeck.txt.gz. So we will use this file to demonstrate how the how to copy the compressed data into a table, and then we will actually query the data to validate. And if you want to know more details about compression, again you can go to my channel, search for the video in here and type for compression. It will give all the concepts related to compression. Okay, but for this certification curriculum, you just need to load a compressed data file into a Hive table, so by running the load command. So don't get into too many details with respect to compression for this. Just follow this wiki page, and it talks about the file to be pre-compressed and then copy into the table. And also you can actually set something called Hive exec compress dot output equal to true, and it will compress the data before loading into the table. So we will see both the okay. So now we have the table already. First we will copy a file which is in my GitHub account, this largedeck.txt.gz, and the data that is compressed has to match with the structure of the structure that is defined while creating the table. So if you remember our deck of cards table, describe formatted deck of cards, it has the delimiter as pipe, and the input file format is text input format. So the zip file also has to adhere to that structure, and also it has to have three columns. Okay, the file is under there are multiple files, so I'm copying from this location. SCP, and this is the server where I have to copy the files, and then I will copy it to the home directory on the server. So the file is copied. After compression it is only 3.4 MB, but if you uncompress it is pretty large file. Okay, now we already have the file in the home directory. What we have to do is load data, because we are copying from the local in path, and our path is root large, let me get the file name, largedeck.txt.gz, paste it here, and I want to append to the existing table, into table deck of cards, and hit enter. Now that file is copied. If you do describe form, already we have done the describe formatted. If you want to list the files under this location, you can say dfs minus ls, give that location, and you can see that there is a deck of cards.txt and there is a deck of cards.txt.gz. And if you select from this file or select from this table, you will see earlier there are only 52 records in this table, but now if I say select star from deck of cards limit 1000, it will give 1000 records. It has millions of them. If you want to get the count, you can say select count of 1 from deck of cards and hit enter. It will take a while and then we will review. So it is done. There are 54,526,000 records, which includes our earlier 52 records as well. Now we have created another table, and as part of the insert demonstration earlier, and if you do describe formatted on that table, which is deck of cards 01 and hit enter. Now you can see that delimiter is not pipe here. It uses the Hive default delimiter, which is null character. And now while loading data into the table, I want it to be compressed. Okay. For that reason, what you have to do is you just have to say that MapReduce output needs to be compressed. Again, if you go to this link, they have this parameter set Hive exec compress output. Okay. And if you are dealing with sequence file, you can also change the compression type from block, none, or record, from block to none or record. If you say none, it will not compress. If you say record, it will do the compression at the record level. If you say block, it will do the compression at the block level. Okay. So in this case, I am not worried about this parameter, but the main thing is this one. First, let us validate the parameter value. For that, we just need to use set command and give the parameter name, which is Hive exec compress output, and it is false. You can set it to true. Okay. And before actually running, let us see what is there in this location. DFS minus ls, paste the link, and you can see there is a file. You can also say cat and you can see that data is visible, but you don't see the delimiter because the delimiter is null character. Now after running this insert statement, you will see a zip file rather than regular file like this. Okay, so let me run the command insert into table. So we are not doing insert overwrite, insert into table, and our table name is deck of cards _01, select star from deck of cards. Again, if you want to do any kind of transformation, changing the file format, compressing the files on the existing data in Hive, or applying the transformations, applying the cleansing rules, any kind of transformations, be it the delimiter level, be it the file level, be it the data level, you have to use this insert statement and then select the data from the table in the proper with the proper transformation rules, and it will do the magic for you. Behind the scenes, it will run the MapReduce job, and using that MapReduce job, it will apply all the transformation rules before loading into the final table. So now we will see the output or review the results after this command is done. If you do the DFS minus ls, you will see a compressed file under the same location pointing to deck of cards 01 table. Now it is done, and do the DFS minus ls on this location. You can see the files with extension .deflate, which means that the files are compressed. The earlier file which we query and insert into this table from the first version, before copying the large deck in the deck of cards, it does not have the extension. So this one does not have the extension, but these two have the extension. And also you can preview the data by running select star from deck of cards _01 limit 100. Instead of 52 records, it should show more in this case, and the data structure is as per our understanding, or it matches to the table structure. So that being said, so far we have covered the load as well as the insert command. The load is, if you have to load the data into the Hive table which is already pre-transformed, then you can use load, because the load itself does not support the transformations. You cannot enforce any kind of transformations while doing the load using the load command. Insert command uses MapReduce, and it is slower than load, but if you have to apply any transformation rules or data cleansing rules or aggregations, anything that needs to be applied before copying data into the target table, then insert is the way to go. It uses MapReduce in the MapReduce to process the data and load into the target table, and it is relatively very, very slow compared to the load command. That being said, I hope you enjoyed the content on the channel. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. If you have any technical questions, go to Stack Overflow and raise the questions with appropriate tags. If you want to discuss further about certifications or big data, please join my LinkedIn group. It's called ITversity-certifications, ITversity-bigdata. And finally, if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will get to see a lot more content like this over time. Thank you. Bye.